quand on est complice, puis t'es la boisson. Tu n'as qu'à voir tes baguettes.
Eu vou cá falar um pouco com o Paulo do grupo HBD que está na Ilha do Príncipe, para que ele nos fale um pouco do turismo, da destinação do turismo para a Ilha de São Tomé e Príncipe. I'm going to talk with Paul. He represents group HBD in Príncipe Island. I'm going to talk to him about the tourism destination in general for São Tomé and Príncipe Island. So Paul,
hello,
how are you? How this market is going for you? How this showcase is going for you?
Well, going very well. English market is very important to São Tomé and Príncipe. People do love the nature, and nature is what São Tomé and Príncipe has to offer. The wonders of the islands. However, it's quite an unknown destination, so we need to be here to show people that the islands exist, and that it's very easy to get there.
Okay, so you telling me that São Tomé and Príncipe has absolutely a lot to benefit from this market?
Yes, of course. São Tomé and Príncipe is for travelers, not for tourists.
Okay.
For people who really want to be connected to the reality and to know the destination, people need to feel the island and to understand how to be happy, and that's something we can understand by going to São Tomé, to be connected with the people, because in São Tomé people are so happy, they are so friendly, that is a lesson when we travel and to understand the destination more or less.
So I could understand that the group that you represent, HBD, is in Príncipe Island.
Yeah, well, São Tomé and Príncipe are two islands. So we have the main island of São Tomé and we have the small island of Príncipe. And our project is aiming to show to the world that it's still possible in Africa to create development without harming the nature and with respect to the local population. So we've been working the past 5 years to create all the infrastructure that is necessary, so now people can come and can benefit from all the wonders that Príncipe Island has to offer.
So it's a sustainable tourism, right?
Yeah, mostly to be sustainable, so future generations, those who live in the island can benefit from the tourists, and those who will be visiting the island can enjoy all the beautiful that the island has to offer.
So since São Tomé and Príncipe has been part of this event, the flux of tourism has been increased? Do you see the difference?
We need to ask to check the statistics, but I believe that English people have traveled more to São Tomé and Príncipe. In the beginning, people stayed only in São Tomé. There was no chance to go to Príncipe either because there was not enough flights and no good accommodation.
Okay.
Now they can travel, there's a daily flight between the islands.
Oh.
They can stay in really great accommodation at Príncipe Island. To be honest, the best hotels in the country exist in Príncipe Island, so it's time for you. If you've been there once, it's now time to come back and to visit Príncipe Island.
Okay, I'm gonna let you tell the people how they can benefit more and more from going to Príncipe. São Tomé and Príncipe, but Príncipe is not really known, I think, for certain tourists.
Well,
so I tell you now, invite them, tell them, come to Príncipe Island and what you have seen and what you guys have done to attract the tourists in São Tomé and Príncipe.
We have the national park in São Tomé and in Príncipe, the Obo National Park. So as you arrive in São Tomé, you can do a lot of activities. You can visit the cacao plantations, the coffee plantations. You can do hiking, bird watching. You can also do all those activities at Príncipe Island, Príncipe Island Park. At Príncipe Island, you have endemic species of birds. So people just go there. We just found an owl in the south part of Príncipe that only exists on the island. So that has been a reason why people go to the island.
Okay.
However, there's a lot to be seen. You can do turtle watching, you can do squirrel watching, you can snorkel, you can dive, you can do game fishing, they can just swim on the warm seas.
Wonderful.
Like 30 degrees Celsius.
Awesome.
They can experience the exquisite cuisine, the local flavors. see how cacao is grown. Mm-hmm. People can do even their own chocolate.
Oh, that's amazing.
See how vanilla grows. On each day they can do different experiences. And well, it's 12 hours daytime and 12 hours nighttime, so there's plenty of things that people can do.
Oh, as you have seen, São Tomé and Príncipe is the destination to go. So, Paul said it all. Prepare your luggages. We're flying. Thank you.
A nossa ilha é muito linda e só precisa conservar essa beleza natural.